Hi, good day. I'm Dr. Tiu from Tunku Abdurrahman University College. I'm a senior lecturer in Faculty of Computing and Information Technology. Today, I would like to show you how Internet of Things and Artificial Intelligence get hitched with current technology. We know that Internet of Things is not a new term. It has been popular a few years ago, since we have a very well-known or very easily connected internet capabilities using any device that is surrounding us. We know that Internet of Things is talking about devices, talking about things, everything that is having the capabilities to connect to the network. And because of these connections, you can perform more things. You can do actions or you can command some device to do certain things, like connecting your computers with your house refrigerators or your house aircon or even though your car. You can actually monitor and see and also preview the device status. What are the power consumption of these things, and are they going to having how long of the usability rate as well as the range in terms of time and so on. If you forgot to turn off the lights, you can also using Internet of Things capabilities features by using your mobile phone to switch off remotely. So since IoT is not a new thing, that means it must be a lot of things out there which is available for us to buy and use it. Let's take a look on this list of items with some of the fancy and creative features such as Quirky Egg Miner. This is an egg holder that can help us to measure or to monitor the egg status. It can tell you the freshness of the egg if you forgot when is the expired date that is stated when the time you purchase it. It can also help you to order online automatically by connecting it to your cell phone, and it connects to the egg supplier as well. Then the egg delivery will come to your doorstep, ding dong, and when they know your egg miner is actually calling them to refill your eggs. Next thing, a smart water bottle. It will actually tells you how long that you haven't consumed water in a day. We know that we need to drink at least 8 glasses per day, but how about have a smart bottle that tells you and reminds you have to drink water all the time? It also will be very useful when you want to know your kids in the school whether they have consumed sufficient water or not by texting you a WhatsApp through the Internet of Things facilities. Then we have a lot of house electronics appliances such as pitcher, microwave ovens, air purifier, or even though an electronics toothbrush that can help you to scan by having a small cameras at the toothbrush tip to see the condition of a teeth, and we'll show you some of the good examples by playing a YouTube in your handphone. So this provides the additional services by the service provider or the vendor seller to monitor, to assist on taking care of your device, whether it's functional or not, through the warranty period and so on. A more fancy thing can be seen from this right upper corner. There's a umbrella. It can connect to the internet. It can check the weather situations. When you are indoor, you just need to look at the umbrella color, and it tells you whether you need to bring it along or not when you go out. Hash baby pads. It helps us to monitor the baby health status by measuring the mass, the weight of the baby before and after changing the diapers. So it can actually helping us to calculate the number of pee or poos by the baby, whether it's in the normal range or not. But they require some human practice to fulfill the needs of the analysis work. That means whenever you want to change a baby diaper, you must use the pad to change it for you or for us to get the accurate results. We can see from this diagram, it shows us that the connected things getting more and more towards the time, the years. Until 2020, it's approximately 50.1 billions of devices connected. You can imagine that how many things beside us are actually connected to the internet. For me, I have a cell phone, I have a laptop, and I also have a desktop. And I have a number of CCTV in my house that help me to monitor house conditions. They are all connected to the internet. So it can be easily more than 5 devices is connected to the internet. That contributes to the number of connected devices as you see in this graph. Besides having the total number of connected devices, there's another thing that brings IoT become more popular. Think a bit about the incrementals of storage or memory size. For the left hand side is something like historical things. When the time 1956, if you want to have 4 megabytes storage, it will cost you a bomb, 30 thousands per month. There's no limit. It's the kind of services they need to pay for every month, 30 thousands to get 4 megabytes. And you want to travel, bring along, you need to use a forklift to carry the items with a plane to other place. It's not that easy. 40 years later, 1994, we have a memory card stick. We call it compact flash. 4 megabytes, $300. Nowadays, we're talking about teras. 1 terabyte micro SD cards. It costs you around 1,000 ringgit Malaysia. It's not only about total number of devices connected and memory size increments with a lower cost and so on. It's also contributed by processing speeds. Thanks to the manufacturers from Intel AMD, from Pentium 1 to Pentium 4, followed by Core 2 Duo, Dual Core, Quad Cores, i3, i5, i6, and now we have i9. And we have a server levels processing unit like Xeon processors, Agilex for the edge devices, as well as other processing units for specific purpose like graphic from NVIDIA and so on. And also thanks to the protocols that is being created by some of the global organizations such as MQTT, HTTP, TCP/IP, and so on. Moreover, also for the cloud computing services that is currently available, like Google Cloud Platforms, Amazon Web Service, Microsoft Azure. Then, when talking about communications, we have a big revolution when it comes to having a wireless communication to replace the physical cable connected. They actually solve a lot of problems that is brought up by these physical cables. Protocols like Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, near-field communications, long-range wireless networks, and so on. It's helped a lot to set up a lot of edge IoT devices to send the data for data locking purpose and so on. And also the edge devices require some processing capabilities that is managed by operating systems. We no longer need to install the entire Microsoft Windows, okay, or Red Hat Enterprise versions in the small devices because we have a lot of lightweight operating systems like Arduino's platforms, ARM platforms, Debian, one of the Linux distributions, and so on. They are all available. Then it comes to utilize this data and do some process that is involved in the research, move up to the implementations that tie us to AI or machine learning and so on. By utilizing some of the frameworks from TensorFlow, Keras library, and so on. So we have the rise of Internet of Things. What can Internet of Things do? It enables your house connectivities by turning your house into a smart home. It can control your refrigerators, TV, washing machine, computers, printer, aircon, CCTV, even though your cars, by using your small handphone device. You will get conveniences and higher usability on these devices. Beside your house, it helps us on our working or even though some of the manufacturing factories. Instead of having a lot of human resources, labors to work on a certain procedures continuously and repeatedly, why not we just design a robot to do the same thing? You can maintain the quality as well as the consistency of doing work. Have a lot of labels, you may have these problems, human errors. When you like to buy things in the shop, if you can make it more simpler, more convenient, make it a smart retailer. This picture showing in 2012, one of the famous city in Korea. At that time, people already started to use smartphone, scan the items and barcodes and straight away buy it the items you deliver to your home before you actually reach the doorstep. From customer point of view, to go into the shops, if there's someone's actually introducing or telling you more details about the products that you want to buy, I think this is what customer always needed. And of course, if selling is cheaper price, we even love it more. About the shopkeepers or even though a shop owner, they would like to know more about the customer needs, the customer feedback or satisfactions, whether they like to pay a visit to the store or not. So if the shopkeepers or the shop owners can provide securities, entertainment, best services to improve the sales, why not? They just install IoT solutions in their shops. And also, it can provide the stock maintenance to make sure the stock is always available by putting more sensors on the goods racks. Have you ever checked out the recent cashless convenience store? Like I show you in these two pictures, one is from Amazon Go, and another one is from CloudPix in China. Of course, it's not limited to these two convenience stores. There are more, like JD.com, NTT Data, eMart24 in Korea, and so on. So basically, the idea is people walk inside without having any cashier or security there, but the whole shop is installed full of cameras to have a view on every angle in the store to monitor the customer's behavior and analyze what they buy and so on. So some people may even though test whether the shop having this intelligence to detect them, open up the packets and having the food inside. So when the moment they walk out from the shop, it actually charge their credit cards immediately. This is how it works. In terms of medical field, the healthcare providers would like to have Internet of Things devices to be installed at the patient side. Let's say have elders who having the remote patient monitoring devices. So it gives the GPS locations of the patients whenever have an emergency case happens, inform the respond team, give certain services, provide a useful guidance as well as advices to the patients to take care on their own. Utilities is more about water, electricity, gases, even though garbage collectors and so on. This helps the city utility service provider to monitor the resources. They put on a water metering, quality monitoring, as well as the gas metering on different part of the pipes to monitor the gas pressure from one side to the other side to perform a leakage monitoring. So all these solutions come back to the one point, which is about connectivity is already a kind of religion, regardless for human or non-human. Anything that is connected to the internet, as it connects every part of the city and turns our city to be a smart metropolis. What is about artificial intelligence here? When we talk about artificial intelligence, you may link it to machine learning or even though deep learning. They define it as different levels. Artificial intelligence is having the biggest regions of this entire thing. It is a development of intelligent machine that allow the machines to think and do what human doing. Machine learning is having the capabilities to learn thing itself that provided humans to do some explicit programs on the machines. Deep learning is even more inner layers because it defines the ways of machine to learn the new things that tie up to the neural network that we have in our brain. We call it artificial neural network. Code the machines to perform deep learning. How does this work? Let's imagine that we have a picture of cars. In order to let a human, a newborn baby, to learn this is a car, how long do we need to take? 1 year, 2 years, or even though 3 years? Can we turn the machines into what the baby performed in these 3 years? Logically, yes. How to do? It backs to the ways how human can recognize a car. In computer science, we will program the computers to segment the car into a smaller pieces to recognize the shape of each group of pixels. Then we further into a smaller group of pixels and recognize the shape again. I call it as the characteristics of this group of pixels, the relation between this group and the neighboring group of pixels. The deeper layers it goes to can help the machine to recognize more items that come to the neural network. Another simple example here. Let's see how we ask the machine to differentiate, to recognize what is cat and dog. We have a stack of cat images, and we define this stack consists of only cat image. And we let the machines to go through machine learning and deep learning process. We segment study the shape of the cats in terms of each different size of the group pixels and the neighboring group pixels, and it become a nodes to links from one decision to another decisions. Then come up with the outputs cats with a constructed or learned knowledge. We call it model. With this model, when you feed in another image, it will tell you, yeah, this is 94%. Looks like a cat. Same thing we apply to the dog itself. So after we understand how AI basically works, how can we merge AI and IoT? Straight away go to some use cases here. Automated vacuum cleaner. I believe everyone know what is this. And I still remember this is actually one of the final projects during my bachelor degree time about 15 years ago. So we can see this is a sensor-guided machine. It sends surrounding whether there's a hole there and the height of the floor and so on. So we can move with the wheel and together with the broom, of course. Then you can turn around and recognize map on the brain itself so you know where it goes, where it haven't go through. And it's selling about 2,600 something. What do you think nowadays the price? Anyone can guess? Yeah, less than 100, you can get it one. So this is what we call it, impossible become possible things. Because things getting more familiar, a lot of vendors come up with their own design, competitiveness. At the end, this thing will be down to something that everyone able to own it. This slide shows the self-driving vehicles consists of varieties of sensors, including ultrasonic sensors, laser sensors, a long-range sensor sense the surrounding cars, or even though a normal light sensors or cameras to see the surrounding. So this is all the inputs that we have, including GPS location and so on. Then we apply artificial intelligence to process on these informations. Like object detection, it can be able to detect the cars. This is a car, this is a human walking, passing by, and so on. As you can see, the left-hand side is showing the real case scenario that's already on the roads, manufactured by Tesla company. And this slide is showing some scene monitoring projects. For the left-hand side, you can see it can be applied in a smart classroom. Right-hand side will be laboratory's usage to detect people in the laboratory, the action, and the cross-camera behavior detections. The students can be face recognized and take attendance. The bottom part is the industry restriction zones or some of the safety vest and helmet detections that is required to replace maybe a security because the CCTV itself is able to detect and tells the management fulfill the security requirements and so on. So this actually is done by our students from our degree final projects. Let me introduce to you some of the hands-on work which is provided by this OpenVINO framework under Intel. As we know that previously, when we talk about machine learning, it may require hardware capabilities like graphical processing unit, GPU. Some of the youngsters may thought that GPU is useful for playing games, but actually we can use this devices to do more fancy work, to let the machines use this GPU to perform the thinking as what humans do. Thanks to Intel that they provide a free resources for utilizing not GPU but Intel processor itself. You can do the same thing to perform AI works. So we can perform some pre-trained models for public usage such as age, gender, emotion analysis and so on. This is what I want to show you. Okay, so I'm actually detecting myself using my webcam and running 5 models. That includes my face detection or identifications and the gender detections you can see here and my age. Yeah, I review my age, although it's not so correct. Emotions, whether I'm in happy mood, because it's been trained to know, recognize this is a smiling face, or surprise mood with a round shape of mouth. That is how AI works and deploying the real case scenario. Free resources, everyone can do it. Utilizing the sensors to sense and perform something or applications, that will be a demo for Intel OpenVINO. Maybe some of you from secondary school or maybe waiting for a result, do you think secondary education is enough? For me, I don't think so. It's just a part of the learning process only. If you think about tertiary educations, you should get a degree due to the competitiveness and self-recognition nowadays a society who might recognize your hard work, your knowledge, and also your qualifications. There are many ways to get degree as a pathway. You can go through a pre-use or foundations or even though a diplomas. At the end, you get a degree certificate and being employed. or you want to further study your postgraduate, also can. No problem. You have include this IoT and AI in various programs that is under Faculty of Computing and Information Technology. We do have PhD programs to work on computer science, masters, and also a number of bachelor programs. And we also have a pathway to go to the bachelor degree. Let's go to our diploma programs. And also the foundation programs is another option to go to degree programs. You may have the opportunity to learn what I have shown you throughout our program. And if you have more information, please come to me or any IOC admissions contact. That's all about my talk. Thank you.